the tiny hamlet of Fledborough, gives its name to the railway viaduct over the River Trent, close by to the High Marnham coal-fired power station. The viaduct, now closed, was opened in 1896 by the Lancashire, Derbyshire and East Coast Railway. Approaching the viaduct from the east bank of the river, this former plate layer's hut is passed, not by the Lineside as is usual, but built snugly at the bottom of the embankment, sheltered from the biting northeasterly winds which blow down the floodplain of the Trent. 59 identical brick arches comprise the land-based structure. 20 arches on this, the east bank, and 39 on the west bank, close by High Marnham. Each arch has a 30 feet span, and the whole constructed in engineering brick. The river crossing is by four steel girder sections, each 110 feet long, resting on three pairs of braced steel caissons. Standing on the central girder section and looking west, the arches over the floodplain lead one's eyes to the coal discharge bunker of High Marnham Power Station. The central girder section looking east towards Lincoln, the once end of the line. Now the LD&EC tracks terminate at High Marnham. The film follows the remaining LD&EC line eastwards to Warsop. The train of coal has just run through the exchange sidings and will unload at the discharge bunker. The film is a compilation of cine taken in the mid-80s and video taken January 1998. The train of empties comes through the exchange sidings but has to wait for an incoming train before it can enter onto the single line going east towards Tuxford. The train approaches Tuxford, going over the East Coast main line, where electrification had just commenced. Now a commercial building, the former LD&EC station, shown in 1998. Tuxford West Junction box in the early 80s, a great central type 5 box. After leaving Tuxford, the line traverses gently rolling pastureland. the rarely used sidings into the brickworks at Boughton. To the left of the sidings, no sign remains of the once Boughton station. The interesting point lever has a cast plate, T. Summerson and Sons, Darlington. No guess as to who supplied the chairs and track work. Boughton Junction, the junction for the disused Bevercoats Colliery branch, now controlled from Ollerton Colliery box. The branch, 4.5 miles long, had one interesting feature, the Boughton Brake Tunnel. The arch, with a keystone for possible lettering or dating, and an inset in the brickwork for a non-existent plaque. Back at the junction, a coal train heads for High Marnham, passing on the far left the concrete base for the signal box burnt down during the 1984-5 miners' strike. Pictures taken just before the strike show the pristine box as it was and its associated semaphores. Running eastwards, the light engine passes the Rexco Coking Plant on the left and Ollerton Colliery on the right. The signal box is another great central type 5, as are all the subsequent boxes. Rusty, overgrown sidings lead into the Rexco Coking Works from a line which once ran south towards Bilsthorpe. The mileage marker, 5¼ miles to, I presume, Mansfield Junction. Back on the main, a train of empties runs past the Thoresby Colliery distant signal. Thoresby Colliery box in the mid-80s. A coat of paint desperately needed. The levers are pulled off for a westbound train of empties from High Marnham. February 1998, and a train of empties from High Marnham arrives for Thoresby Colliery. The outside of the box has had its coat of paint. One mile down the branch to the colliery. A trainload of coal backs out of the colliery into the reception sidings. The loco runs around its train, but there is no eastbound exit from the sidings. The train has to back onto the up main before heading east to High Marnham. A look at the eastern dead end of the sidings. A train of empties arrives, and again the loco has to run around its train before proceeding up the branch to the colliery. half a mile west of Thoresby Box, is the Dukeries Hotel, which is half a mile from the centre of Edwinstowe on the Nottingham Road. The hotel was patronised by LD&EC passengers using Edwinstowe Station, the former station building on the upside of the line, is now occupied by a small woodworking concern. Across the tracks from the station building are two former LD&EC properties, the station master's house, detached, and a semi-detached dwelling. A couple of hundred yards past Edwinstowe Station, the distant signal for Clipstone West Junction. West Junction, one corner of a triangular track layout, the former LD&EC line running east-west, with east and west junctions feeding lines to South Junction, down to Mansfield concentration sidings and beyond. A train of empties from the west turns off the LD&EC at Clipstone West Junction, heading south for concentration sidings. The signal is off at East Junction for a coal train from either the Shirebrook or Worksop area, destination High Marnham. Again approaching from the Shirebrook direction, a pair of Class 20 locomotives head a mixed freight, this time round the west curve, to concentration sidings half a mile to the south. Two track workers push their 010 vehicle along one of the rails past the two concrete post signals at South Junction, and the Class 37 follows and takes the west curve towards Clipstone West Junction box, having run up through the concentration sidings. The Class 56 train of empties comes off South Junction and runs down to concentration sidings. The light engine will pick up a loaded train of coal from Clipstone Colliery, situated just south of the box. The guard of the train of empties from Clipstone Junction climbs down from the cab and receives instructions from the yardmaster. Class 56 locomotive, which earlier went to Clipstone Colliery, now heads north with its coal train to Clipstone South Junction. The 20s, having deposited the wagons in the empty siding, cross over the main and back down into the reception sidings. Back on the LD&EC, now passing Welbeck Colliery Jct, a train of empties heads east towards Clipstone. Class 56 with loaded HAA wagons and the 20s with HEA wagons heading to Shirebrook Junction, past the light engine heading towards Clipstone. A loaded train backs down from Welbeck Colliery onto the up line, then crosses over to the down line and off towards Shirebrook Junction. The Welbeck Colliery branch, 2¾ miles long, was opened in 1915. In 1998, a train of empties heads down the branch to the colliery. up from the colliery, passing the village of Warsop and approaching Welbeck Junction. On the main line, the oil train passes the former Warsop station, destination the oil depot there. Just after Warsop station, a train of coal heading west passes over a farm track on the approach to Warsop Junction. Class 20 is halted on the up main, allowing a 37 with a train of empties to depart Warsop Sidings. Shunting over the line into Warsop Main Colliery. Shunting duties complete, the pair of 20s head to Shirebrook East Junction, passing on the left Warsop Junction and the Midland Line to Shirebrook Junction. 1998, and a trainload of coal passes by Warsop Sidings. This is the end of the LD&EC line, which continued straight ahead where the electrical control boxes now stand. Round the curve into Shirebrook East Junction and joining the Midland Line from Shirebrook to Shire Oaks. The LD&EC used to cross over the Midland Line into Langwith Station, and the positioning of the bridge girders can be clearly seen where the rock is cut away on top of the embankment above where the locos are halted on the Midland.